After nearly 2 weeks since a 10% cut took effect for elected officials and unclassified employees, Governor Eddie Calvo repealed such action by signing Bill 543 into law. He did so at the request of Republican leaders in the legislature.
It did take me some time to sign it. Again, I was torn. In one hand, the bill that had been, the omnibus spending bill that had come to me, really the only significant savings came from that amendment.
The 10% cut amendment was originally included by Senator Aline Yamashita in Bill 507, or the governor's spending cuts bill. The amendment raised concern in the community, especially those in the island's judiciary and health care systems. GMH Administrator Joseph Virgo was happy with the signing.
I am relieved, I'm sure they are relieved, and it takes certainly a weight off everyone's shoulder, and it certainly would have put a halt on the progress that we're trying to make here at the hospital.
He notes at least 90 physicians were impacted by the cuts, with some even threatening to leave the hospital for better paying jobs off island.
So it potentially could have had a really, really devastating effect on the hospital. This averted what could have been a very bad thing for the whole community.
Calvo, meanwhile, says he doesn't anticipate the cuts being retroactive.
But again, it was something that lapsed into law, and we've dealt with it. And so we anticipate that their wages and their pay will be, put back in order in the next pay period.
Ultimately, Calvo says now was the time to work together because, as the audits show, signing Bill 543 still doesn't escape the financial crisis this government continues to face.
But there's also a commitment by this administration that is unwavering that we need to make cuts moving forward in this government to restore fiscal stability. And I want to be very loud and clear in that message to the legislature. Though that I signed Bill 543 into law, we do anticipate wanting to work with them in dealing with these fiscal issues that aren't going away.
Reporting for Guam's News Network, I'm Ken Quintaniza.